walking down the street in Cloyne, you walked past two statues of two gods. One is that of the Catholic Church and Jesus Christ, and then on the other side is the God and the statue of Christy Ring. And you know, I think that's something that never leaves you.
I just remember Laurie Marr as an older man, in his late 60s and early 70s. There was a team of the millennium and a team of the century, and he made both teams.
I suppose Ratneure is the home place of Nicky Rackard, and Nicky Rackard Cup is named after him. We see him as a hero down in Ratneure, I suppose.
To hear Joe speak at half-time during games with our club, if things weren't going well, or no matter how they were going, the passion that he spoke with, you wouldn't hear a word in the dressing room.
From a GPA's point of view, the purpose of bringing these launches back to the clubs of, you know, who the competitions are named after, was really about kind of tapping back into the heritage and the culture of the GAA, linking, you know, our inter-county players and our inter-county games back to the clubs.
I think it's been great. It's kind of really gone back to what the GAA is all about.
It's brilliant that the GPA are kind of promoting these competitions more.
We had interviews, we had song, we had dance, and we covered all the cultures of the GAA, and it was a wonderful occasion, and it's great to have the GPA down here.
It's good that the GPA are recognising that bring it back to where the grassroots are.
You know, it's wonderful for the young people and the local community as well, you know, to celebrate their hero.
I think the tier championship is really important because, like I said, it gives us like a level that we're able to win. And if we win our championship, we can go up and we can compete at the next championship and hopefully win that as well.
The biggest thing about improving your hurling is competitive games. So the idea of these championships is to kind of give lads all around the country, not just in the top tier hurling counties, competitive hurling games. So it gives them a chance to improve their hurling.
One of the things with hurling, it's a brilliantly skillful game, but a small difference in skill level can result in a massive difference on the scoreboard.
Teams that are of a particular standard are all playing against teams of equal standard. And I think the reward for those two teams that get to the final is that they get to play in Croke Park.
For sports people all over the country, Croke Park is a famous hallowed ground, if you like, and it's only right that everybody gets the chance to play there.
For anybody who comes to the game, the games are absolutely fantastic, really competitive. They're so close, like you're looking at real fine margins to find in each game.
It's our All-Ireland at the end of the day, like it's our championship, so it's great to be able to get out and play it. Like
every team feels here they're going out to win the competition, win everywhere, get to Croke Park and win.
I think every team in it, they feels like they can win it.
We don't expect to compete for the likes of your Kilkennys, your Galways, your Tipperary, so to get to that standard we need a stepping stone. So the Ring, Rackard, Joe McDonagh and the Maher competitions provide that there for all counties. Gives us a chance to get up a level and keep progressing up through the levels to get to that Liam McCarthy eventually, but hopefully someday.
It's good for young lads coming up as well in the club that you have something to aspire to.
It's their Liam McCarthy Cup. Let's make this happen, girl. We're gonna show them something.